this year. Phrygia and Pamphylia in Egypt, and in the parts of Libya came Cyrene and strangers of Rome, Jewish and proselytes, Cretans and Arabians. We do not hear them speak in our own, in our tongues, the wonderful works of God.
Praise the Lord. Thank you. Acts chapter 2, you can have your seat. God bless you, man. The Bible says that when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all gathered together in one place. Now, according to Bible scholar and a little research I did, that out of about 120 brethren were gathered together in that upper room. This was immediately after Jesus Christ was taken up to heaven. You know, in Acts chapter 1, we read about how Jesus Christ was taken up to heaven. In verse 4 and 5, you know, and verse 8, the angel appeared to them and said, "The same Jesus that you see taken up is coming back again." He said, "But you have to tarry here in Jerusalem first. You shall receive power after the Holy Ghost come upon you, and you shall be my witnesses." The power that the Holy, that Jesus Christ promised them, he said that the Holy Spirit came upon them in the upper room in the form of what? Clouds of fire. The Bible says that when the fire came upon them, they begin to speak in other language. When I was growing up, we have this little Bible story for children. You know, I don't know whether Sister Joyce still has that type. We saw it. The fire rested on them. It came on them. So the fire came from heaven. And as a result of the fire, immediately the fire came, something happened. They began to speak with other tongues. According to the research I made in the scripture, that there are about 120 brethren gathered here today in that place. Maybe we are just 20 people here today, but the fire is coming.
Amen.
The fire is coming.
Amen.
I know some people have already received the fire, but then the fire is coming.
Amen.
In a greater way.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So they were gathered together. Mary, the mother of Jesus, was there. The woman whom the Lord, you know, borrowed her womb to carry the Lord Jesus. She was right there with them. The Bible also makes us to understand that even his brothers and sisters were there. Which means after Mary borrowed Jesus her womb, and she also had other children. They were there waiting, you know, for the fire. Just like that song that we sang, that they were gathered together in upper chamber. They were gathered together in one accord. As we are gathered here together with one mind today, fire of God will come upon us.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please don't let anything distract. Children, go moving up and down. We can take the sweets and keep it for them at the back. I don't want anything. This is very important. We have been praying, I know. But we need to be sensitive to what God is doing in this place today. Praise the Lord. Fire came from heaven. Fire came upon them. You know, with one accord, let our hearts be together. Let nothing distract. That's why we try, you know, to just focus on God. Don't let anything distract you. Put off your phone. If you don't answer your phone now, you will not be hungry. Children, be quiet in Jesus' name. At least for this moment, till we finish. Okay? Praise the Lord. So they were there, and the Bible says that the cloud of fire came upon them. If you go on to read in the book of, time will not permit me, the book of Acts chapter 5 verse 14, Acts 5 verse 14, Acts chapter 8 verse 12, that these women who were there on the day of Pentecost, they went about, you know, working for the Lord. They began to prophesy. They began to preach. Even in the book of Acts chapter 29 verse 9, let's open to Acts 5 14. They were going there, they became witnesses, which means there is a reason God does not just send down fire. He sent down fire for what? For a purpose. There is a reason for which God sent down fire. Now, when we look at the word fire, as we are trying to open our Bible, what does the word fire mean? According to the dictionary meaning of fire, fire is a process in which substance combined chemically with oxygen from the air and typically give out bright light, heat, and smoke. Which means for fire to burn, there must be an air that must be blowing into it. And I compare this oxygen to the Holy Spirit, which he said, "Ye shall receive power after the Holy Ghost comes upon you." Which means the fire of God cannot come and empower you when you are not born again, or when your life is not right with God. Thank God for the woman of God that prayed and led us in prayer. She said, "We must consecrate ourselves." And that was the first thing the Lord told me this morning. You know, the kind of fire that we are talking about, women on fire for the Lord, is the kind of fire that will make you to be a witness, that will make you, you know, to impact your generation positively for the Lord. The kind of fire we are talking about is the fire, you know, that will make you to go places for the Lord, to do things for the Lord. It's the kind of fire that will make you to be a voice to the nation. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And today the Lord is going to make you, you know, a wonderful instrument in his hand. Even if you think you carry fire before, the fire of God will be multiplied. You know when we had kerosene to fire, or we have petrol to fire, how does it do? It burns more. It burns more. And as a daughter of destiny, as a child of God, we need to keep burning. We must not become cold. You see, you cannot see a fly, you know, rest upon a hot place now. Flies lies on what? On cold food. The reason why you have been having those nonsense dreams, somebody sleeping with you in the dream, somebody doing this to you in the dream, is because your life is cold. When your life is too hot for the devil to handle, he will not come near you. I pray for someone here this afternoon that the fire of God will come upon you and consume every activities of darkness in your life in the mighty name of Jesus. The Bible says for this purpose, the Son of God was made manifest to destroy the work of darkness. The fire of God is coming upon you. The fire of God is coming upon you. The fire of God is coming upon you in the name of Jesus. So as the fire came, the church increased. A church that is not growing, it means the fire of God is not there. Pray that the fire of God will be restored upon our altars. In the name of Jesus. We have ministers here. We have pastors who are here. We have evangelists here. That the fire of God will be restored upon our altars. In the mighty name of Jesus. So like I said, fire needs something to burn. It does not just burn like that. You understand? It does not just come out like that. Just anyhow like that. Something must bring it out. Something must bring out the fire. So when we talk about fire again, fire is a burning sensation. It's like, you know, when you hold a candle in your hand and the thing is burning you, what do? You begin to shake. You cannot stand on your feet again. What makes us to fall under the anointing? It's the fire of God. It's the power of God. It's the presence of God. It is not until you push somebody. You don't need to push. When the fire is there, when the power is there, even if nobody lay hands on you, the Bible, look at the way our feet and just fell the other time. The fire of God is what does that. It's a burning sensation. You cannot carry the fire of God in you as a woman and then you remain on the same spot. When you have a fire of God upon you, you understand, when you get to a city, you must shine for the Lord here. Not the city. You know, some people, when they come to Europe, say, this is the way they are doing it, and you are blending. If you see yourself already blended with the land, it means the fire of God is not there. Today, cry to God for that fire.
Amen.
Amen. That it comes back. And then when we look at fire again, you know, it's like a discharge. You know, when you hold a gun in your hand, you say, fire. You fire it now. You know? And when you say, you fire. Fire can also mean that you are dismissed from a job. So today, all those powers that have been assigned to your life, I dismiss them. In the mighty name of Jesus. You begin to wonder, why is it that the devil is against women? It started from the beginning. The devil is against the seed of women. He's against us. Whether we believe it or not, that's why, you know, we come into prayer, women, women, women this, women that. Because the devil is constantly fighting against women. Today, every power, everyone that has been assigned, who has been monitoring you, those ones that they did not take a visa and they came all the way from Africa, you are still here, you are still seeing yourself in the village. Today, by the power in the name of Jesus, I dismiss them from that evil assignment, that monitoring assignment, in the mighty name of Jesus. We fire them. Women of fire, fire, you dismiss. You dismiss. Women of fire use their power spiritually. You can see a woman that is gentle in face, but don't go near her, she's hot. Today you become hot for the Lord.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Women on fire for the Lord. Now, what does fire do? I know God has moved here today, so I'm trying to rush a little. What does fire do? Number one thing is that fire proves things. It proves. It proves. Amen. What we want to, what we make clay now, when we want to, you know, like we used to do in Africa, when you are molding the clay in your hand, after you finish molding it, what do we do to it? Why are we putting it in the fire? To harden it, to prove it. So we need the fire of God to prove us, to harden us. If you run from Europe, you run from Spain, you run from, you say, oh, the land is too hot, you keep running. You don't know maybe the reason why God brought you here is to do what? To prove you. something, you don't know the strength that you have. And it is important for us to be proved by God. We need to be proved by Him. It is part of the process that we are His daughters. So sometimes, you know, He just makes some things to, you know, happen to us to do what to prove us. The book of Psalms, He says, you know, you brought us to a place to make men to ride over our back. By the end of the day, what did the Lord do? The Bible says, He said, He has brought us to a place what? A place of abundance.
A wealthy place.
The Lord is taking you to that wealthy place.
Amen.
That situation you are going through now, it's not forever.
Amen.
God is proving you. Because if you are going to talk and people will listen to you, you must have passed. There are some things you can't talk about if you have not been there.
Yes, ma'am.
If you have not trusted on God for something, how can you encourage people who are trusting God for something?
No.
You don't understand what it feels.
Yes.
So God is proving you. Don't run out of the fire. My ear may go so tired. God is speaking to someone this afternoon. Don't run out of the fire. It seems as if it's getting hotter now. Don't run out. It's a process. It's proofing you. So that you will come out well, stronger, better, beautiful, glorious than you have ever been before. When you are a woman on fire for the Lord, fire can prove you. God can use His fire to prove you. If you keep running, you keep running all your life. They talk to me, you leave church A, you move to church B, you from church B, you move to church C, you will keep running. The fire is there to prove us, to correct us, to make sure that, you know, we conform to the image of Christ. It's like you are doing an exam. Fire examine us, prove us. You know what you say? You want to prove your worth. You want to prove your worth. Let's see how much you have on the inside of you. You have been sitting there receiving grace. Then God gives you a challenge for you to handle. And God wants to see how much you have on the inside of you. And you know when you don't pass an exam, you don't move to the next class. Have you?
Yes.
At least some of us will go to primary school. If you don't pass primary one, will they put you in primary two? That's why some people spend 8 years, 7 years in primary school. Why? Because they did not pass. Today you will pass.
Amen.
You will stay calm. Because to pass, you must come, you must be calm. If you don't read, how will you pass? Even if God will remind you, how will you? Do you understand? If you don't read, what will God remind you of? So, sisters, don't run out of that fire. It is for proving. God is proving you. You are in a place, maybe people are misbehaving to you, they are doing everything. You have reason, you can walk away. And God says, stay there. You are in a place, you are going through a process, maybe you are trusting God for something. You want God to give you a husband. You want God to give you a child. And everybody around you, they are making jest of you. Say, when will you burn your home? In fact, when they are doing dedication upon dedication, say, you now every time you carry me, you go dedication, what you go dedicate your home with? God help us, women. Let's be sensitive to each other's feelings. Let's be sensitive to each other's feelings. There's no married woman that you see that does not want to have a child. So stop asking them, when are we coming to eat rice? If you want to eat rice, cook rice in your house. Stop asking insensitive questions. You see somebody had egg weight, extra weight, the tummy is becoming bigger, and you know she's trusting God for a child. And you are saying, you are overweight, so what is your problem? Is she eating your food? You don't know maybe she's taking nutrients so that she can conceive. Let's be sensitive to people's feeling and emotion. Let's not just open our mouth and talk anyhow. Because the same fire that proof can also consume. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
In fact, the worst one is on social media. Somebody who have not seen you for 10 years. He's saying you have changed. Do you want it to be the same as 10 years ago? I don't also understand for people. And you know, some of them are so wonderful with it. They will write it on your profile. They don't know how to use inbox. So people lack discretion on Facebook. Even people who have not met you before will start preaching to you. Do you know whether she just got up from a state of sickness and she just took that picture thanking God that she's alive? And you're saying, how are you not looking like this, You know? Now only one you just born. You know, go do quick, burn another one. You don't know whether she just had a miscarriage some days ago. Let's be sensitive to each other's faith. The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. That's what I'm saying today, so let me not go there. Amen. Number two thing that the fire does, Hebrews chapter 10, verse 31. The Bible says it is a fearful thing to fall into the hand of God. For our God is the what? A consuming fire. Fire consumed. And the Bible delights about God to a consuming fire. When we talk about consumption, amen. When we talk about consumption, Consumption means destruction, utterly destroy. When you say consume it, that means there's no remnant again. Nothing is remaining. Praise the Lord. Fire consume. Now, God consume out of his anger. We also have other scriptures in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 29. Hebrews 12, 29. Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 24. Deuteronomy 4, 24. Deuteronomy 9, 3. And God is a consuming fire. There's a story, a terrible story in the scripture. Praise the Lord. I call it terrible because you know the way they died. The Bible talks about Abihu and Nadab, that they offer a straight fire before the Lord. And they were, you know, they were roasted there. And God is a consuming fire. May you not see the consuming aspect of God's fire. In the name of Jesus. May you only see the good part of the fire. Because fire also purifies. When fire purifies, it takes out the debris. It takes out the dirty. It takes out all the things that are not of God there. Fire purifies. And of course, fire can spread. Fire spread. When you start a fire here, it can spread to other places. You know, from that scripture we read, from that place, from the people that gathered, around 120, they went from there and they begin to do what? Preach the gospel. The Bible makes us to understand that acts, that there are even women among them. So, and even as the Lord has promised us, we read it also in Acts chapter 2, that in the last day I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, your sons and your daughter, even your aunt's maiden. How many people are God's aunt's maiden here? I'm number one on the list. When you are God's aunt's maiden, you are God's servant. Mary said, it said, behold, thy aunt's maiden. We'll talk about it in January. Say, the Lord, be it unto me according to your word. When you are the Lord's aunt's maiden, you are the Lord's servant. Which means you can receive the fire of God. Now, what are the type of fire we have? I'm going to talk about two type of fire that I put down there. I wrote down three, but I'll make it two. Number one, the type of fire. You know, it's the fire from the Lord that enable you to be a witness and a light in the midst of darkness. Just like the Bible says in the book of Isaiah, it says, arise and shine, for the light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Which means the fire that comes on you to become what? A witness for the Lord. And that fire is coming on you. The Lord is raising evangelists in this place. People will go and speak the word. When I say evangelist, it's not really a title, because we are all called to preach the gospel. Amen. Praise the Lord. The fire of God is coming upon someone today. To go and rise up from this place and to go and preach the gospel. In that way, even if you don't understand that, how am I going to serve this God? God is going to put his fire on you. You will understand. You will know the way he wants you to go about it. Just like our sister received direction in January and she started the Children Bible Club. It's the direction from God. So another person received direction, she started writing. Another person received direction, the Lord promoted. And all our testimonies shall be permanent in the mighty name of Jesus. And of course, I've talked about the consuming fire of God. Those are the two type of fires I want to talk about. The consuming fire of God. The fire that destroyed. That destroyed. And that fire is the fire that go against our enemy. It is the fire that go against our adversary. So it is a fearful thing, a dangerous thing, to be an enemy to a woman who is on fire for the Lord. A woman who is on fire for the Lord is a witness. The book of John chapter 4, if you start reading from verse 5 downward to the end, talks about the story of a woman who can counter Jesus. John chapter 4 from verse 5 to the end. The Samaritan woman, she encountered Jesus by the well. And when she encountered Jesus, she got her fire from there. Immediately, what did she do? She went about to become a witness for the Lord. She went into the city. In fact, I'm sure the people that listened to her most were the men. The men she had her fears with. So what if you have walked on the road before? What if you have sold your body before? That is your past. It's forgotten. It's gone. Now, God can still make you a voice, even into those places where you had commands before. In fact, the reason why God made you to walk that walk is so that you will understand what those people are going through and you'll be able to reach out to them. Many of us, immediately God gets save us and you are delivered from that kind of lifestyle, you begin to look at those who are doing it with, I feel for you. You are pitying them. How many times have you gone to them to preach the word of God to them? So as the fire is coming on you, you are receiving the fire to be a witness for the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Now, how can you, who can get this fire? Who can get the fire? Anyone can have this fire. But there is a condition to it. Now, when the fire of God comes down, like I said, fire, the fire of God purifies, at the same time, the fire of God consumes. It consumes. So if you are not born again and you are calling down the fire and you are saying it's a fire, fire, it's not everybody that can call down fire. You can say it's a fire, Thank God. It sounds melodious in the air. But there are so many fire that are not going anywhere. In fact, when you are calling down fire on your enemy and you are living in sin, you are calling down fire on yourself. Because fire burns. Fire burns. So for you to be qualified to call down the fire of God, you must be born again. Genuinely born again. Not that I came to Europe and I joined a church. So we are going. Praise the Lord. I joined a church. There must be a day in your life as a woman that you must know that on so day, I gave my life to Jesus. It is not just enough for you to just join a church and just be part of the church. You must know in your life that today I gave my life to Jesus. When you have Jesus Christ as a personal Lord and Savior, your life is free from sin, and you are asking Him for help every day, then you can call down the fire of God. You can call down the fire of God. Now, who can call down, who can call fire? It is only those who are recognized by heaven that can call down fire. Elijah in the book of 1 Kings, let's go to it quickly. 1 Kings, chapter 18. Is the Lord speaking to someone this afternoon? Is the Lord speaking to someone this afternoon? Amen. Praise the Lord. Now, who can call down fire? Number one person that can call down fire is God. God Himself. Send your fire, Holy Ghost fire. He can send down fire from heaven. Like He did on the day of Pentecost. The Bible says what? Fire came down from heaven. They were praying. They did not even call the fire. But fire came. So God can send down His fire. And of course, in the book of 1 Kings chapter 18, when Elijah, you know, was doing the contest, you know, wanted to prove God, you know, to them that God, the God that answers by fire, is God. And I said, you know, Elijah is a prophet of fire, fire. And he used the fire, fire. He roast people and I said, if I be a servant of God, let fire come down from heaven. He called down fire. Even in this book of 1 Kings, he called down fire. He called down fire. Let's just read it. Verse 37, 18, 37 say, hear me, O Lord, hear me, that these people may know that thou art the Lord God. Now, when Elijah was calling down fire here in this place, he was calling with a purpose. He was calling that the fire of God would come down to prove himself. So when when you call down fire, you cannot just be calling down fire just for fire's sake. God, prove yourself in my life. Prove yourself in my situation. You know, he was asking God to send down the fire so that the Lord will show to the people that is what he is God indeed. You know, they were contesting that who is the right God, who is the living God. The prophet of Baal, they have come from morning to afternoon, nothing happened. You understand? And Elijah called unto the Lord. The Bible says in verse 38 that the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt of sacrifice and the wood and the stone. Hey. Even when the fire of God came down, he consumed not only the wood. You know, he has asked them to pour water. Take time to read that scripture. It was not just a dry wood. If you want to make fire now, we will use what? Dry wood. You understand? If your gas is wet and you light it, will it work? It has to be what? Dry. For fire to come. Which means you must be empty if you want God to pour into you. So if your heart is still full of bitterness, it's full of hatred, it's full of people who offended you 20 years ago, you still keep it in your heart, the fire of God cannot stay in you. Your heart is still full of pride. As a woman, you understand? The only thing that occupies your heart is how to buy the latest design in town. The fire cannot come in there. The fire cannot come in there. You must be empty, must be dry, there must be a space for the fire to come. This is the only place in the scripture where the fire came upon the wet offering. He poured water. The Bible says that even consumed the stone. So the fire of God is such that it can consume anything. It's powerful. It's potent. Why don't you whisper to God and say, Father, I empty myself before you this afternoon. let your fire fall upon me. Father, let your fire fall upon me. Even into all those places. You know, there are some, you know, there are women that the devil has made compartment in their womb, in their body, and he has kept things inside there. Begin to ask the Lord, let your fire touch the into my bone and my mind, into every place. Let your fire come into me, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Amen. In Jesus' name we pray. The fire came. Even the dust, the fire leaked. And lick up the water that was in the stench. And when the people saw it, verse 39, 1 Kings 18, 39, they fell on their faces. They said, the Lord is God. The Lord is God. When the people saw the fire of God coming down, what did they do? They shouted. Which means when you are a woman on fire for the Lord, when people see you, they see God in you. Mm-hmm. They know you carry something. You don't need to talk. You don't need to do anything. But they know that there is something on the inside of you. They know that this one does not have time for any other thing. The fire of God is burning. When they look at your face, they are seeing you burning for the Lord. They see that the only thing, when they wake you up in the morning, it is God. When they ask you in the afternoon, it is God. When they ask you in the evening, it is God. Be laughing. You know what, why you are laughing. Praise the Lord. When they come in the midnight, it is God. The Bible says, the seal of your house, do you want? Consume me, envelope me, cover me. That is the grace the Lord wants to release this afternoon. There will be witnesses. You know, I thank God I give with you today. I give thanks to God. That if from the January retreat, God will raise 3-4 women who are going out to do something and their life has changed, then there is hope for Spain. Amen. There is hope for Spain. Amen. The story of this land is going to change. Amen. It's going to be a place where they say, women are on fire for the Lord. Amen. And it stands with you and I. Like I told you, fire spread. Bye. If you have the fire of God on the inside of you, your husband will feel it. Even your children will feel it. You say, hey, he's not coming to church with me because he has not seen that Jesus in him yet. Fire is not there yet. Fire is not there yet. You understand? You know what we burn our gas? We can put it at lowest. Some people, they are just burning. Some people, they are not burning at all. Some are just burning at their lowest. Some, they are very hot. You understand? So if you have become cold, the Lord Almighty will rekindle that fire in you this afternoon. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Fire speaks for you. You don't need to speak. That was what happened here. When they saw fire, what happened? What did they say? They said, the Lord is God. The Lord is God. The same people who said they called their bar. Is it not the same people? If you read from that 1 Kings chapter 18, they were shouting since morning to night. And the fire did not come on their offering. In fact, Elijah even made just for them. Say, shout to the Lord. Maybe your God has gone on holiday. He has traveled. Who serve a living God? When you are, when the fire of God come upon your life as a woman, you understand? When your mates see you, when they are gossiping, they know they cannot bring gossip to you. It's because you are cold. That's why they are gossiping with you. Mm-hmm. Praise the Lord. Yeah, did I have the time to sit and begin to gossip about somebody? Where souls are perishing? It's God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It's because they say that you can't, you know, every story in the church, you are the one that knows, it's because you are cold. Yes. But when people have problems and they say, yeah, please, sister, I want to see you. You understand? It's because they see you have fire. You have something. Fire attracts. There's no way you make fire that fire will not call attention. It will definitely call attention to itself and bring people. And bring people. There's no way, if you see fire here now, what will everybody be doing? We'll be running towards it. And do you know something? Fire can also be quenched. May your fire never be quenched.
Amen.
If you are being quenched today, God is the God of many chances. Amen. May you come alive for the Lord.
Amen.
So primarily, women on fire for the Lord are women who are going to become witnesses for the Lord. Spain is too cold. You know when you want to do the things of God, nobody will encourage you. You yourself encourage yourself. After all, I have to say, David encourage himself in the Lord. So you are waiting until people say, hey, we're done. It's when you succeed, that's why people will say, we're done.
Yes.
Do you understand?
Mm-hmm.
So encourage yourself in the Lord. Look at Deborah in the book of Judges chapter 4. She's a very wonderful woman. The Bible says that Deborah, the wife of Lapidus, she was a judge. She's a lawyer. She's a judge. You understand? At the same time, she's a leader, a political leader. When the men were sleeping, she led the war. She took the battle to the gate of the enemy. Where are the men? Forget it, we are in a men's world. Who told you? Even the Lord said in the scripture that even your young women, your servants, will receive the fire of God. So the fire of God is open to us, many who will pick it up. So you think that, evangelist, if you know me, before I get married, I used to do this, I used to do that, but you know, with all this baccalaureate now, what do I do? As you are running, they will follow you, carry them with you. When you are on fire, even your children, they will line up beside you. They will be following you. Amen. Okay? Before God give you that child, you pray, you bind, you fast, and now the child is not the excuse. You see, you know now when somebody gets married, you know the way it used to be. So the fact that God has given you a husband now is the excuse why your fire has now gone down. So no time for choir rehearsal again. Your fire, if you get married and your fire go down completely, it means you have married the wrong person. I'm sorry, but that's the truth. Praise the Lord. Because the Bible says that one shall chase a thousand. Truth shall do what? So don't go and marry a brother who is already wet. Who has no potential, is not dry, is full of himself. You understand? You know there are some brothers, they are the only one that knows it all. Nobody else person knows anything. If you say this, what somebody sent a mail to my husband, he said, I saw the picture that you are doing, you know, even though it's not new to me, but well done. I said, what did you use to reply? I said, that's why they don't go far in life. It's not compulsory you appreciate what people are doing, but you know you don't water down what others are doing. When you see people succeeding, celebrate. Women, we need to change our attitude. Somebody is sharing testimony of God's goodness. Tap into grace. Celebrate. Rejoice. You want children, you don't go for child education. As you are going, as you are standing on the altar, and you are just looking like this, Father, what will you do my home? Rejoice first. Rejoice first. God does not hold anyone. As we will be praying today, every yoke of barrenness in this place will be broken.
Amen.
Forever. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
When you see you lack something and you see it's another person, celebrate grace. Don't be feeling intimidated. You are not empty. I told us, Mama, as you are looking at you are not empty. You think God cannot use you? He will even use you. He will use you greatly, powerfully.
Amen.
You understand? When fire comes upon a woman, it doesn't look at her. So even as if this is to be a year, she can catch fire.
Yes.
If you want fire, Elijah wants fire, he called that fire. If Deborah was just sleeping like every other woman in the house, what would have happened to Israel at that time? Not only did Deborah receive fire from the Lord, she inspired other women. Look at Jael. In that same chapter, Jael went. She rose up. The leader, the captain that escaped from their hand, the woman was there in the tent. You say, yeah, but I'm not working, I'm a sit at home only. But that doesn't mean you cannot carry fire. From your room there, you can be sending fire out. When that man was escaping, what did the Bible say? Jaya, use time, bring him into the tent. He said, do you want, let me give you milk. Even give me milk and water and everything. And she recognized. Do you know why Jaya could recognize that was an enemy? It's because she carried fire. When you carry the fire of God, when you are a woman on fire for the Lord, you see things. You see things, your eyes are, because fire purifies. That's another day in your house again. You see things, you don't suspect people. You are not suspecting people. Some people are good at suspecting. I suspect that woman is a witch. Who told you she's a witch? Because she did not greet you yesterday. You don't even know maybe the woman, the poor woman did not even have food to eat. She has her own trouble. You know who may God will deliver us? We carry so many problems and put it on our head and say it's our personal problem. You call somebody nothing before, then you are offended. You don't even know whether she's in the toilet and the phone is not with her. He said, but she did not call me back. You don't know whether the little boy she has at home has already deleted the thing. You think it does not happen? Or sometimes you'll be calling and the phone is ringing and the other person is not saying it. Even if she ignored your call, don't give yourself paracetamol on another person's edit. Praise the Lord. When you're a woman on fire for the Lord, you don't have time for all those petty things. You put them aside and face your life. Praise the Lord. So when you are a woman on fire for the Lord, you see things clearly, directly. You see things the way they are. Not that you assume things. Bible says, Deborah was a prophetess. She prophesied. She see things. You see things are not happening around. We need the gift of prophecy. As a woman, the gift of prophecy can come upon you. And you need to prophesy. You begin to prophesy and declare things. Not that you are forming it in your head. The Spirit will give you utterance. When the fire comes upon you, when you are handling the microphone like this, before you finish saying one line, people are already on their floor, on the floor. Because what? The fire of God is on. Carry grace. When you're a woman on fire for the Lord, you see things clearly, just like I said, and you hear clearly as well. You have strategy. Deborah had strategy. She planned the war. Judges chapter 4. She planned the war. And they went out and they succeeded. So I was talking about who can send down fire. God can send down fire from heaven. Elijah also called down fire. You know, like I said, Elijah is a fire prophet. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank God that Elijah is not the only great prophet in the Bible. Otherwise, maybe everybody will have died by now. Because left to some people, they will have used fire to finish everybody. It's not all your enemy that must die. All my enemies catch fire. Yes. Some must be roasted by God. But all of them cannot die. If all of them die, how will they see it when God do that thing that they say will not happen in your lifetime? Yes. Some enemy must die. And they must die. Because those who say, not in my lifetime will you carry your life, then they must die.
Yeah.
And because they have declared it. Because the Lord has said that I shall be what? A fruitful vine. My children shall sit around my table. So if anybody has vowed and said to you that not in this lifetime would you have been not in my house, will you go beyond this level? Then they are ready to die. In fact, without you calling fire, how can they come near you when the fire of God is on you? How can they oppress your life when the fire of God is on you? When they stretch up their hand, then they catch fire themselves. And that kind of fire that go out to you against your enemy is a fire that consumes. It's a fire that burns. So I will say to us this evening, this afternoon, women, let us connect to the green fire. And let's stay connected to him. So Elijah is the prophet that called that fire. He roasted the first king, second king chapter 1. All the people that came until the other company came and said, please, me, I know you are a servant of God. You don't roast me. You know that one borrow himself brain. I was saying, how do you call it? I said, don't roast me with fire. So you can, God can send that fire. You can call that fire. And of course, you can be thrown into fire. Daniel, the book of Daniel. Well, let's open quickly as I begin to round up on this session so that we can go into a time of prayer. There's a story. There are some three young men that were thrown into fire in the book of Daniel. In the book of Daniel. My Santa Mama, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Father, we bless you. In the book of Daniel chapter 3, the people knew that this young man, that they love and they serve God. So they went to connive with the king and said, make a decree, this is it. So sometimes the enemy can set you up to put you into inside fire. When they were hacking all this plan in the book of Daniel chapter 3, you think God was asleep? No! He wasn't sleeping. So sometimes when some things happen to us, I begin to cry, but why did it have to happen to me? If it does not happen to you, then who will it happen to? Who should it happen to? It is necessary if you are a woman on fire for the Lord, then you have to pass through fire, walk through fire sometimes. And the Bible makes us to understand, look at what I say, even when you pass through fire, it will not do what? It will not burn you. Why? Because you yourself are already what? Carrying fire. Does fire control fire? If the fire of the Lord is upon you, no matter the fire, no matter the setup of the enemy, no matter the arrangement from the pit of hell, you will escape. You will escape. Even if they gathered against you, they say, what you are doing is what you want to begin to do next. God always make a way for his own children. These three men, young men, they were thrown into the lake. They were thrown into, the Bible says, calls it there, the fiery furnace. It's not an ordinary furnace. It's a fiery one. It's a fiery one. It's a fiery one that they throw him into. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Even when they took them to the fire, the Bible makes us to understand that the men that took them into the fire said, the fire did what? Consumed them. To tell you how terrible the fire is. So I don't know what fire you are passing through now. But the fire of the Most High God comes upon you afresh today. That fire you are passing through will not burn you.
Amen.
I don't know whether I'm speaking to someone. That fire can be a negative report. It can be lack of a job. It can be, you know, it can be persecution. Because when they know you are a child of God and you are doing things, they begin to rise up against you. It can even be a fire that is fighting your testimony. I say, hey, that testimony you share. Okay, let's see. But speak to you. That fire that you are passing through now will not consume you.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
God is bringing you out of that fire.
Amen.
To shine forth as his gold.
Amen.
Because when you know when we make ring and you pass through to fire, when it comes outside to come, you know how gold used to be very dirty. But when the goldsmith beat it here and there, bam, 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 jump it here, put everything here, and they put it to the fire, and they refine it, what comes out? Beautiful. You are coming out beautiful.
Amen.
You are coming out gloriously.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
God is making a way for you.
Amen.
God is making a way for you.
Amen.
You are coming out victoriously.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Even as women, there is a fire that follows there. You know, underneath our clothes, you can even lift up and open to others. Even you cannot even confide in your pastor, you cannot confide in anybody. But there is a fire burning up underneath. I pray for such women today. That underneath fire, that inner fire, oh, your Holy Ghost, quench it.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are coming out without a scar.
Amen.
You are coming out without a scar.
Amen.
You are coming out without a scar.
Amen.
You know when fire burns, it always leaves a scar. But you are coming out without a scar.
Amen.
Even if you cannot show it to anybody, so that it's not only things you know, women as we dress up now, you can't many things on that. But that fire is not going to destroy you.
Amen.
Is there a hearing husband? Who is we are going to be praying for our husband shortly? Who is making life difficult for you? And he said, you cannot even, you know who you go and report to? Did he beat you? No, he did not beat you. Did you say this up? He did not do this. But the man is making the home a terrible place for you to stay. You are coming out victoriously.
Yeah.
And now are you coming out? The fire of God is going to arrest that man today.
Yeah.
And we'll give his life. If fire arrest now. If fire break out now, who can move again? My Santa dear. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
God. So even in the fire, even in when they put them in the furnace, the Son of God was there with them. He said, when you pass through fire, I will be with you. He has not brought you this far to leave you now. I don't know who I'm talking to this afternoon, but the Lord has a plan for you.
Amen.
It is burning so hot now.
Amen.
But God is bringing water to quench it.
Amen.
He's holding you. You are coming out without a scar.
Amen.
You are coming out without a scar.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And by the time they throw them into the fire, but by the time they were coming out of the fire, they were coming out as what? Shining, victorious, standing up with their head raised high. Because what Nebuchadnezzar saw, what he did not see before. He said, were there not three men thrown into the fire? Daniel chapter 3, verse 25. He answered and said, no, I see four men loose. They cast them into the fire bound, loose, walking in the midst of the fire. And they have no hearts. So this is where the word is coming. I say it again. I don't know, maybe someone that is watching me online that you are here. You are coming out on hearts.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You know, sometimes the enemy set up fire to destroy us. That was the fire they set up for this man. For this young man. Maybe they have set you up in your place of work. It's like, we know it's a child of God. We know this is it. Every demonic setup that the enemy has planned for you, the Holy Ghost fire will arrest such trap today.
Amen.
And burn it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are coming out on scratch.
Amen.
You are coming out on scratch.
Amen.
You are coming out on scratch.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Then Nebuchadnezzar came near, verse 26, Daniel 3, to the mouth of the burning fiery furnace, and spake and said, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Did you hear again? You know when Elijah called down fire, the people they saw, what did they start saying? The Lord is God. Now, this name Nebuchadnezzar that said they must you know, bow down to his golden image. He said, ye servant of the Most High God, as you are coming out of that fire, people will see you and recognize your God.
Amen.
They will see you and recognize your God.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He said, come forth, come thither. Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego came forth of the midst of the fire. And the princes, governors, and captains, and the king's counselor, being gathered together. Now, they were not ordinary men. No. Stand up on your feet. They were not ordinary men that were gathered. You know, the president of the nation is there. So the governors were there. The senators were there. Just like we have in Europe. You understand? Uh-huh. The president is there. The prime minister is there. The senators are there. The parliamentary members are there. And in their very hands, those who stay back and say, Shebi, they are going into the fire. She's not coming out. They will stand and watch you come out of that fire in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because the fire of the Most High God is coming upon you in the mighty name of Jesus. And upon whose body the fire had no power. So even when you walk through the fire, like he said, it will have no power over you. Why? Because fire does not consume fire. When the fire of God is upon you, no power of the enemy can consume you. No power of the enemy can defeat you. When the fire of God is on you, no disease will spit your body. Massacre can never shame you. Thank you, Jesus. He says, nor was an ear of their head singed, neither were their clothes changed, nor the smell of fire had passed on them. Even though they passed through the fire, nobody saw the smell. They shall be no loss. No matter what you are passing through now, you are not going to suffer any loss.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
You are not suffering any loss.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And the fire came. Now, after this fire came, so we can be thrown into fire. And of course, there is a fire that is coming after our stay here on earth. That is the lake of fire. May you not go to that fire.
Amen.
May I not go to that fire.
Amen.
It's not just only by prayer, but by the work of our hands. The way we live our life, by the way we do things, we know that there is a fire after fire. So if you are here this afternoon, you have not given your life to Jesus. I think the first fire you have to come out from the lake of fire. Because when you are not born again, you are already in that fire. So come out today and surrender your life to Jesus. And as you come out of this, you know, as you come out, the Lord Almighty is putting you into another fire,
amen,
which is the fire of the Lord. And you go out and be witnesses to him. Anytime I look at the story of Deborah, I get challenged that this is a woman like you and I. She combined her role effectively. Praise the Lord. If you are a woman on fire for the Lord, to do things in the house will not be difficult. To balance your, we know we have to do many things together. Sometimes I wonder how I manage to do all these things. But it is because of the fire of God that is burning. And that fire, as we are going to be receiving this afternoon, is a fire, you know, that will not make you sit down. You will combine things together and exert. You will exert as a mother. You will exert as a sister. You will exert as a father, you know, as a friend. You will exert as a lover.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yes. Women on fire for the Lord are women who take care of their husband. I think we are done with the life one. They are done now.
Let's finish it. Let's talk our own.